Welcome to the new journey to paradise. My name is Michael, and today we continue from the last part, the restoration and reformation topic. But before we start, a quick reminder. Please subscribe, like, click the bell icon, and share the videos with your friends and families. They're very important, so please listen to them, watch them all. We also have a new mini-series of the new journey to paradise for all our patrons of Triple Grace. You can join Patreon and support Triple Grace, and then you will be able to watch all the videos in the mini-series. For more information, please go to the playlist mini-series. You can also have an early bird access to all videos that we make. This works as follows. You go to Patreon, you sign up for the Lion of Judah squad, and then you will have access to all videos days before the premiere at YouTube. If you would like this, just go to Patreon. If you feel to support new videos, if you feel to support the establishment of new societies of the Rose in the world, and if you feel to lift up the needy, to help the poor, the suffering, the nameless and faceless, then for any act of loving kindness or for your donations, you'll find all the information in the description box below. So now, without any further ado, let us start now with the continuation of the topic of restoration and reformation. So, last time we had the 95 theses, and in the 95 theses we went to thesis number 26. Yes, so let us now start and continue from number 27. Filth has entered the churches, and sin sends a stinking aroma to heaven. Unfortunately, today we see so many churches that are in bed with the world, in bed with complete tolerance, in bed with sin and evil. And their sins, they are smelling so badly that the aroma will go to heaven. And the Lord is smelling this sins that are coming out of their churches, and he is very unhappy with it. So we have to make a change. We have to change the church from the normal, usual, standard church that we have to a church with blessings, and that's the church 2.0. 28. Come out of her, says the Lord. No worldly authorities has any power over you. We have to follow the Lord alone, God Yahweh, and come out of the world. Our dependency on the world and on money and on career and on power is far too much. We cannot serve two masters. So we either come out of the world and serve the Lord, or we remain in the world and forget about Yahweh. Choose wisely. Stand with the Lord. 29. Tear down the man-made structures of unbelief and replace it with the pure temple of love in your hearts. Love of the Father should be your foundation in your heart. You have to bring forth the love of Yahweh into the nations. And this is an action. Do something. Show forth his love so that the people will see a great example. Not only talking and listening, but also doing something is very important. So that you can take down your man-made structures of VIP people, videos, films, games, whatever you do, and throw them out and replace them with a pure temple of love in your hearts. 30. Shine forth in the glory of the Lord day after day, and set a new standard and ensign in all the world. Yes. Every day you will do daily sacrifices. You will go and show to the world that Yahweh is within you, and that you bring forth His love to the nation by lifting up the needy, by helping, by supporting, by showing forth that you really have the heart of the Father. And then the world will recognize, will see, oh, there are different new people. This is a new standard in the ensign of the Father in the world. There's something has changed. Look at them. They're totally different from the old churches. And you will be recognized for your good works. I say it, good works. Yes. It is important to be active. Justification by faith does not stop at the cross, but it's just the beginning. I will make another teaching in our mini-series about justification by faith. 31st. It is a time to stand up from your church benches and to walk out into the world, to be the example of righteousness by doing active good deeds daily. And this is what you will do if you establish Societies of the Rose or join Societies of the Rose. You will go into the world and be an example. 32. Come together in love, unity and support in Assemblies of the Lord. We have a whole teaching about love, unity and support. Watch it. It is so important for this time period that we are in now, the period of judgment, that we come together in assemblies of love and righteousness. 33. Invite God to your love meals. Share your resources and food. Secure one another in any case of calamity and love your neighbors by providing the help needed. This is what the Rosarians are doing within the Societies of the Rose and outside in their community, in their neighborhoods. 34. Pool your resources for kingdom purposes. We all have access. We all have something more than we really need. So we can pool resources together, share resources, so that we can, with this sharing of the resources, advance the kingdom of the Father. We will bring heaven down on earth. Come together, love one another, and share resources. 35. Strip off any fear and step out into the open arms of the Lord. Any religion, any denomination, any church that is based on fear and tells you, oh, you have to do this and this and this and that because you go to hell, is already fake. Step out of any fear and into the arms of the Lord, because God Yahweh will provide for you. He will put you under His wings, and you will be secure forever and ever. 36. Give up your religious doctrines, man-made beliefs, and shameful doings. How many people do I see with very strong religious spirits who claim things that were never written, who say things that they have never received, and then behind closed doors do very bad things. So come out of this world, come out of Babylon, and join Triple Grace. Come into the Societies of the Rose, or if you cannot find one near you, then establish one. You can do that. We want to go into the world to be the example of Yahweh. 37. Instead, walk in the glory under the latter rain into the open for all to see. Excuse me. The Father has said in the Bible that He will pour out the latter rain onto the people in the end times. And under the latter rain, the double portion of the former and the latter rain together, you will operate. You will have everything you need to bring forth the kingdom onto earth. Just do it. Move out. Move out today. Pack your bags and walk with us on the new journey to paradise. 38. Fill the people in the world with envy so that they want to join you and walk in similar fashion. Yeah, the envy of happiness, the envy of glory, the envy of contentment. Fill the people in the world with envy, that they look at you and your society of the world and say, these people are different and they are so happy. I want to have the same. I want to join them right now. 39. Break down the old structures, churches and synagogues. Empty yourself to be filled with the Holy Spirit of God. The Lord says, I will do a new thing. The old has passed. The church age is over. Now empty yourself completely. An old wineskin cannot be filled with new wine. Empty yourself and be filled with the Holy Spirit of the Father. 40. A filled wineskin cannot receive new wine. That's what I just said. 41. Do not rely anymore on governmental structures or human institutions. Rely alone and fully on the Lord. We always say, oh, in case of calamity, there will be the government coming in and help us and rescue us. And there will be retirement pay and there will be social welfare and all this. But very soon, a lot of calamities will come. And then the government will not be able to help you anymore. You should not rely on the worldly structures. You should rely alone and fully on the Father, on Yahweh. Because He is assisting and supporting all of His creation. Look at the birds. Do they have jobs? Do they have income? No, but they have food and they are clothed very well. Same as the flowers. They are so beautifully clothed by the Lord. So even for you, the Lord has everything ready. Just trust fully in Him and open your heart for the Father. 42. Step through the open door onto the righteous path, which will lead you to the top of Mount Zion, where you will enter the holy place and where you will put your heart at the feet of the Father. Walk with us the new journey to paradise. Walk with us to the holy mountain, the dwelling place of the Father. And there is His holy place, and there you will be allowed to enter it. And there you will place your heart at His feet and become His true son and daughter. And He will rapture you into paradise or seal you as one of the 144,000. The time is short. Make a decision. Join us and come out of the world. Walk with us to Mount Zion. 43. It is time to break camp. Get ready to move into the promised land. 44. Leave all old behind. Do not be afraid, because our God will provide for you. 45. Do not look back, but climb the mountain of righteousness with praises and songs. Worship the Father. Sing a song to Jesus. Praise Him. Worship them. Go into your prayer closet and pray. Listen what the Spirit is telling you. But never forget to be in contact with the Father. Always talk with Him. Throughout the whole day, have a contact with Him. Because a strong bond must be established so that you will understand everything. 46. Your rescue has arrived and you will be taken to the place of safety that the Lord has prepared for you. At the end, it is written in Revelation that mighty angels will come to gather the people for the great harvest and bring them to the mountain, to Mount Zion. So the angels will come to your society of the rose as a rescue. He will come and tell you, it is time. We are going now to Mount Zion. It is time for you to be taken to paradise. So just walk with us. Even if you do not understand everything, ask your question. But walk with us together. There will be a lot of videos coming and a lot of understanding will be brought forth. Sign up. Join Triple Grace, the website. Look at everything what we offer. Ask your question, but walk with us. 47. Your cup will run over and your table will be filled with all delicacies. 48. You will finally rest in the arms of your Father forever and ever. 49. Glory to God alone, the Father of the earth and the universe. Yes, do not worship anybody else. Worship the Father and the Son, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. Do not worship Paul, do not worship Peter, do not worship angels. Do not make statues or images. Follow the Ten Commandments. They are not abolished. Whoever says this has no idea what he's talking about. 50. Let no man, church leader, prophet, healer, or witness hold you back. Set yourself free for a new beginning. People will speak against this channel. People will speak against the new journey. They will bring forth any kind of stories from the Bible, any kind of verses that they twist so that it stands against us. Do not listen to them. This is a new thing, and we are in the great Exodus. We are breaking out of Babylon. We are breaking out of the world. Set yourself free for a new beginning. 51. The kingdom is at hand, and you need to separate yourself from the slumbering churches. Most churches are sleeping. They don't know anything about spirit. They don't know anything about dreams and visions. And they are so much afraid of something new. It is the same as Jesus came with the Pharisees. They were so much afraid of something new, so they rejected Jesus. And now they are rejecting triple grace, and they are rejecting me and all other Rosarians too, and all the societies of the Rose. But we are walking in a new thing. Of course we are not the only ones, and we do not want to say that we know everything. Of course we do not know. But we are one way that will lead you to Mount Zion. There are other ways, there are other people who are called in a similar way, and they may do it in another way. But you can walk with them too. You can walk with them, you can walk with us. At the end, we all will be there in a multitude, clothed in white, at the base of Mount Zion. 52. A new dawn is rising, the dawn of the Millennium Kingdom. 53. The time of the roaring lion of Judah as our king, replacing the suffering servant of the first coming, is at hand. Jesus on the cross, it's finished. It was finished on the cross. But what happened after the cross? After the cross, we have the resurrection, the transformation. The story continues. It is not finished at the cross so that you can sit down and wait until Jesus comes back. Now is the time of the roaring lion of Judah, and you can become a small lion too. Just step out. Join us. Listen to us. Walk with us. Bring in your input. Let everything work together. 54. Embrace the love of God and spread it to the nations. The nations are waiting for the coming forth of the sons and daughters of God. The most important part, and this is also why we start with love, unity and support, but we start with love. Most important part is the love of Yahweh, the love of the Father. Even Jesus talked all the time about the love of the Father. He showed it to the world by giving his own life. So the nations are waiting for the coming forth of the true sons and daughters of God, filled with the love of the Father. 55. Grace will be poured out over you. The latter rain has arrived, and you will do mighty exploits in the name of the Lord. Is it not written that in the end time the latter rain will be poured out, and that you will do mightier works than Jesus himself? Now, the time has come. Don't you see it? Don't you feel it? Don't you see the signs in the sun, the moon, and the stars? The time has come. Embrace it. 56. Do not remain seated in the church benches. Stand up. Call for the Lord. Receive his glory and step out into the world. Do not be inactive, sitting there listening to sermons from the pulpit, and then after it closed, you go back into the world. No. Leave your church benches, stand up, walk into the world, and do mighty deeds for the Lord, and receive His glory. 57. A new refreshing wind is blowing, a restoration of all things, and the rebuilding of the waste places. Read Micah. In Micah it is written that there will be a restoration of all things. Even Jesus has said it. I will send the Elijah Spirit, and a restoration of all things will take place before the great and mighty day of the Lord. And the time has come, and we are starting now in the spirit of Elijah to restore the churches, restore the places to glory. 58. But you can only do exploits by being active. The time of reading and talking is over. Now is the time of action. 2,000 years there were preachers in the churches. 2,000 years the people have talked, recited Bible verses. And what happened? The churches declined and declined and declined because there was no action. They were listening, they nodded with their head, and then they were going home, back into the world. And Satan was very happy because now he can bring all his filth through this world to these people because they're not active anymore. Because they're so much afraid. They say, oh, if you are active, then this is works. And you are not saved by works. Of course you are not saved by works. You are saved by grace, through faith. But when you are saved, and your heart is overwhelmed with the love of the Father, then your heart is crying forth to do action, to do acts of loving kindness, to do righteous deeds every day. This is action. Why do you think the Lord has come to the Lake Tiberias after his resurrection in his transformed body? Because the apostle had gone back to the world and was sitting, and he told them, now, do you love me? And if you love me, then feed my sheep. Do action, go forth, do the same as I did. And this is exactly what we are calling you forth to do. Walk as Jesus did. Talk as Jesus did. Teach as Jesus did. And gather the people together for the great harvest at Mount Zion. 59. Holy action in its finest form through love, caring for one another and lifting up the needy. This is a great example for a society of sorrows. Holy action in its finest form. Every day, through love, in the name of the Father, not in our name. 60. Going forth to tell the people that our Father has heard their cries and has seen their tears, and now we have come to lift them up in the name of the living God, of Yahweh. In the name of the Father, we go forth every day, doing daily sacrifices and helping His people. Gather the people together into communities of love, unity, and support. 61. Now is the time of pooling our resources, not spending them on expensive clothing, partying, buying arts at exorbitant rates, or wasting it in games or gambles. No, now is the time to come pool your resources together for the advancement of the kingdom. Not the kingdom of Thailand or the kingdom of Malaysia, no, for the kingdom of heaven, for God's kingdom. We have wasted our money for many, many things. Now is the time to bring it together so that we can advance the kingdom. 62. Now is the time to sell excess and to bring it forth for kingdom purposes, to give it to all who have need. Where have we read that? I think we have read it somewhere. Yeah, of course you have. In the book of Acts, you have read it, because this is exactly what the first assemblies did after Jesus' ascension. They sold excess and they brought it to the apostles, and then it was given to all who have need. Why have we lost the track? Why have we lost the narrow path? Why are we on the right of poverty or on the left of prosperity? What went wrong? It is time to restore the old and tried path. 63. The wealth gained through sins will be redistributed to the righteous. Don't you think that the rich people who are just caring for themselves will go away with their sins? They won't. The Lord will take all their wealth away from them, and he will redistribute it to the righteous, because he knows that the righteous will then take it to advance the kingdom, to lift up the needy, the meek, the suffering, to help Lazarus at the gate. And with this funds they will take the battle to the gate. Which gate? The gate of Mount Zion. 64. The time of huge charitable organizations with huge overheads is gone, because now each and every assembly is its own charity, reaching out to its neighborhood all over the world. 50 people coming together, living the love of the Father, acting together every day, discussing, doing daily sacrifices. Oh, what a wonderful sight! Don't you see it? 65. The true sons and daughters of God do not waste time in talks or conferences, but act in love, unity, and support. Action is required. Don't sit there and listen. Oh yes, everything is so wonderful, but nobody has a solution. Nobody says what really follows after the talks, after the conferences. They say, yes, the situation is bad, and we should change, and we should restore the old ways. But they have no solution. Here, at Triple Grace, you have the solution. You have your way. Build the societies of the Rose. Come together in love, unity, and support, and show it forth into the world. But be active. 66. The earth will see the Sun of Righteousness arising with healing in its wings. It's something out of the Bible. I hope you have read it somewhere. I hope you read your Bible every day and you understand what is written there, and not listen to other people and talk after what these people were saying. No, read the Bible by yourself, being guided by the Holy Spirit of understanding, with wisdom and knowledge. The Sun of Righteousness will arise with healing in its wings. A new group of people with the Elijah spirit, with the love of the Father, going forwards in the world, being placed under the wings of Yahweh. The earth will see all of them, the true sons and daughters of the Father, acting together in huge groups all over the world, in every nation, in every town, on all continents. It will be a great example of the love of the Father all over. And you can be part of it. It's open for everybody. 67. Many of the old traditions will resist us, but nobody can stand against the move of God. Of course, the old will not accept our new ways. They will say, no, where is it written? Where is it what? No, don't listen to them. Pray. Pray to the Father. Ask the Holy Spirit what you have to, if you should join, if you should come together, if you should walk the new path, if it's your destiny to reach Mount Zion. And then you will be shown what to do. 68. As soon as the light of the new will be seen in the darkness, excuse me, many will join us, some due to jealousy and others by wisdom. Of course, as soon as they will see many societies of the Rose in the world, then they want to have the same. Some only because they're jealous, but others because they have received the wisdom through the Holy Spirit. 69. In these new assemblies, outside of the tradition and churches, you will find the peace of the Lord and total support in all situations that may arise. We have talked about this in our complete teaching about societies of the Rose. If you have not seen it, please go back and watch it. 70. We will show that a united kingdom cannot fall nor fail. A united kingdom will be strong. God the Father and Jesus and the Holy Spirit are one in a Trinity. And so they are strong, they are united. And we, as the true sons and daughters of Yahweh, are part of this united kingdom. So we cannot fall nor fail. 71. Coming together daily to do righteous deeds is a pleasure in the eyes of the Lord. Many people say, oh, this is works, we cannot do it. Then read the Bible. What has Jesus done? He has done righteous deeds every day, healing the sick, teaching, raising the dead. He has done daily righteous deeds, and the apostles the same. They went out into the nation to teach, to raise the dead, to heal the sick. They have done the same. Every day, daily sacrifices, every day righteous deeds. 72. Fill your heart with the love of God and bring many people to righteousness. Yes, again, the love of God is the cornerstone. The love of God is Jesus Christ. Fill your heart with the love of the Father and bring many people to righteousness. By showing them the new light, the new way, showing them Mount Zion, showing them the love of the Father, showing them support, showing them daily sacrifices, showing them how to come out of the world. 73. 2,000 years people have preached the good news. Now it is time to bring the good news forth and live it. Preachers, we have enough. Churches, we have enough. Denominations, there are so many. And all are preaching the good news. Some twisted, some in the real sense. But now, where is the action? Where do we live the good news? There's still, the Lazarus is still sitting at the gates. They're still suffering. And the riches become richer and the poorer become poorer. So that means we are not living the good news. We are just listening and sitting, but now it's time to bring it forth. 74. A new child is born to rule all nations with a rod of iron. This is Jesus in the millennium, but also the true sons and daughters of God, as is written in the Revelation, in the messages to the churches. They will rule the nations with a rod of iron. And also this is an action. It's work. Rule is always active. 75. Come forth, all who are hungry and thirsty for the Lord. The time of your rejoicing is at hand. Yeah. Are you hungry? Are you thirsty for the love of the Father? Are you willing to change your life and to become a true son or daughter of God Almighty, of the only living God, and following and doing the same as his only begotten son Jesus did when he was on earth? If you have that feeling, then join us, walk with us, come together and bring it forth into the world for all to see. 76. The new level knows no border, no religions, no creeds, no colors, and no races. You are all welcome. Come as you are. You will be cleaned on the way if you are stained with sin. But do not be afraid. Come as you are. You are worthy. You are worthy to walk the new path to Zion. All are invited at the wedding banquet of the Lord. Yes, there is a difference between the bride and the wedding guest. We know that. I wish for everybody who is listening that they will be part of the bride. But we also know that it's most likely only 10% that will be the bride of Jesus. But for the other ones, we are there. We are there. If you feel left behind, come, talk to us, join us. We will go to the wedding banquet of the Lord, and we will be true sons and daughters of the Father. 78. A time of feasting and celebration has begun as the Lord has chosen his bride. Yes, he has chosen already who will go in the first rapture as a bride. But if you are left behind, don't feel bad. because we will walk to Mount Zion. We will bring it on the way, and we will walk there, and we will be the multitude closed and wide, and we will be standing at the base of the mountain. And the Lord God Yahweh will be on top of this mountain, and we will have access to his place, and we will take it to paradise, and we will be at the wedding banquet. 79. Join the new move of God and be filled with all the goodness of the Lord. 80. The time we were all waiting for has finally arrived. Praise God Almighty. 81. Had you thought that God will leave anybody behind? Never. Many people say, oh, these people will never go to heaven. Oh, these people will never have a chance. Oh, whoever has not read the Bible, oh, who never has spoken the name Jesus in his life will be condemned to hell. No. The Father will leave nobody behind. And everybody will have a chance to join it. Everybody will have a chance for redemption. Everybody will have a chance of salvation. Because Jesus is not about religion. Jesus is about the love of the Father. 82. The wedding of the Lord is open for everybody, no matter from where you are or where you have been. Come just as you are. And Jesus will embrace you, and the Father will embrace you. 83. All you need is to open your heart and to step through the door. The door is always there for you. You only have to walk through it. Even me, as Michael, I can only show you the door, and I can encourage you to step on the new path. I cannot force you, and I do not want to force you. I just want to give you a hint. Step through that door. Go onto the narrow path to Mount Zion. The rest you will do with the Father, with Jesus, with the Holy Spirit together, in your prayer closet, to get wisdom and knowledge and understanding. 84. Please do not reject the invitation. 85. The enemy was dreading this day because it is the beginning of his end. Oh, Satan is so much against me and against Triple Grace and against all the people in the societies of the Rose. And we have problems here and we have problems there, and many people are standing against us. Of course, because he knows when there are millions of societies of the Rose in the world, where will Satan stand? He is losing control. So he is fighting the early beginnings very strongly. 86. Let no one hinder you to come to the celebration. Let no one talk you out of your future. Do not listen to your church elders when they say, do not follow Triple Grace. They will say Triple Grace is from the enemy. I can only laugh about that. They will say, oh, this is a wrong teaching, this has nothing to do with Jesus, and this is about work salvation and all this rubbish with what they will bring for us. Because they have no understanding at all. 87. Enter the eternal rest of the Lord in love, unity and support. You feel it yourself that you need to come together. You feel it yourself that the time has come for unity and for love and for support. You know it, but you had no solution for it yet. But now you have. Establish a society of the Rose in your neighborhood and be part of Triple Grace and be part of the new Son of Righteousness. Then Jesus comes and brings us all forth with his angels to Mount Zion. 88. Look through the eyes of the bridegroom Jesus. Walk in his footsteps. Lift up the needy. Heal the sick. Spread love throughout the world. Do not walk behind Jesus as a servant anymore. Now it's a new level. Now it's your time, as it was time for the apostles after the Lake of Tiberias and after receiving the Holy Spirit. It was their time now to walk as Jesus did before. And now it is our time to do the same, to walk as he did, to talk as he did, to teach as he did about the kingdom of the Father to come. There's only one gospel, and this is the gospel of the kingdom. There's no other gospel. Only the gospel of the kingdom and the love of the Father. It is all about the Father. Love your God above all else, and love your neighbor as yourself. heal the sick, spread love throughout the world. 89. Is it free? Of course. The only action needed is to empty yourself. Replace the old with the new and be ready to move out of the world. 90. Woe to the people left behind in the old. You have no idea of what is coming, and only the love of God can cover and protect you. You can see it already. War is at the doorsteps. Earthquakes are there, storms are there, the weather is getting more and more crazy. All this is there, the calamities are standing in front of you. See them. What can you do if you're standing alone and calamities will strike? You will go down and you will die. It is better to come together in a society of the rose with 50 other people who can help one another to overcome such situations. And this in the name of the Father, not in your own, because the love of the Father will cover and will protect you. 91. No man can give you protection. No man can forgive your sins, and no man can walk for you the path. You must walk on your own. Do not listen to anybody who tells you that he knows everything. I do not know everything. I only know that I was called for to prepare these societies of the rose and to prepare this way to Zion. That one I know. What will happen on the way, the Lord will show us. No man can forgive your sins, only the Father, but you must repent. Being saved means also that you have to repent of your sins. Do not forget it. I will make a separate teaching about repentance. And no man can walk for you the path. You must walk on your own. It is your action that will qualify you to be at Mount Zion. It is not an action that will lead you to salvation, because you are already saved through faith in grace. You are already saved. But now, out of a saved heart, your action will come and you walk that path. But then you have to walk it on your own. First, and then you build a society of the rose, and then you gather the people. But the step has to come from yourself and from your heart. 92. Do not believe in your leaders, but ask the Lord about his wedding and the banquet. He will guide you into the new level. Pray about it. Pray. Say, oh, I've seen something new. Is this correct, Father? Shall I walk towards Mount Zion? Shall I build societies of the rose? Shall I support them? Shall I help them? Is this really the true new level? And then you will receive downloads from the Holy Spirit, from the Father, from Yahweh, from Jesus. Listen to your dreams and visions. You must walk in spirit and truth. 93. You will not find your complete answer in the scriptures or in any sermon. Only the Holy Spirit can show you the path of love. Be ready to be filled. There are so many people talking about Bible verses every day. But at the end, they also do not know how to apply them. Then they go back and sit in the world. This is not what the Bible verses and the scripture are about. They should show you an example. There are pattern inside. But you have to apply this pattern. You have to apply this action into your life. And therefore you will have the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit will show you the path of love. And he will fill you. As it is written, the end times I will pour out my spirit unto all flesh. He will do that. And he's already doing it. Listen to it. 94. Will you become a new creation, the man-child born from the woman, Revelation 12, filled with a lettering, or will you continue to sit in your church, waiting for something that has already arrived? Do not be arrogant as the Pharisees were by rejecting the new level and clinging to the old. Their places of worship were destroyed in 70 AD. Because they were clinging to the old and they could not walk with Jesus together. Now a new thing has come, the spirit of Elijah, and we have to go and join and come together. This is a new way. If you do it together with us as Triple Grace and Societies of the Rose, or if you find somebody else who has the spirit of Elijah and make some other projects and you follow him, that is up to you. But you have solutions right in front of your eyes now. Use them. Become active. Step out of the world and out of Babylon. 95. Walk as Jesus did and show forth the active love of God the Father. Yeah. Become a small lion or lioness. Act as Jesus did. Talk as Jesus did. Teach as Jesus did. Heal the sick. Raise the dead. Bring it forth into the world. The active love of the Father. And do everything in the name of the Father as Jesus did. These 95 theses will bring a restoration to the old church. It will restore the old church to the new level, the Church 2.0. All the information you will find on our website of Triple Grace. You will find information about Church 2.0. You will find about the restoration. You will find it about the 95 theses and many, many other resources. Just use them. Use them and bring it forth. Join or establish a Society of the Rose in your neighborhood. Become a true son or daughter of God. I thank you that you are so kind and listen to this long rambling of mine. I hope it was not only a rambling, but a good teaching. We have to restore. We have to bring forth a new church. We have to make many, many changes. We have to come together in love, unity, and support. And you can be part of it. Do not have to worry. You can come as you are. Even if you are full of sin and you know, everything will be cleaned on the way until you will stand at the base of Mount Zion, filled with the Holy Spirit and clothed in white. And the Father will be there and say, "Thank you, my son. Thank you, my daughter. Well done." Now, please, join Triple Grace. Log in, sign up, read the resources that are there. Follow our teachings on YouTube. Sign up, like, share. Have a look at the miniseries and the playlist. Help us at the Patreon. Become a patron of Triple Grace so that you have early bird access to the videos and that you can also see the miniseries videos. Support our ways. Support the establishment of Societies of the Rose in places where they are really poor, in Africa or in Asia. Help us with our mission to Cambodia. Assist us. And I hope that you are looking forward for the next teaching. That will come soon. Every second day you will see a full video. Listen to it. And I thank you that you are watching these two videos now about the restoration and the reformation. Everything will be restored as it is written. Elijah in the spirit will come to restore all things. And then Jesus' second coming will be, and not before. So if you have questions, please send your question to triplegrace55@gmail.com. And we will make soon a Q&A about all the questions that we will receive. Excuse me. Now, if you have it in your heart, or the Holy Spirit put it in your heart to help us with donations and support, or everything what you need for that of investment or support or donations is in the description box below. I hope that I will see you on the next video. And I hope that you will listen to these videos more than once, twice or thrice if it's necessary, so that you understand all of it. And please also go to the website. What you have heard, you can read there too. All the topics are there. Listen to the mini-series. The next will be about justification by faith. They will also open up your eyes and your ears. Listen to them. Look at them. Be part of it. Become a Rosarian. Join us on our new journey to paradise. And I thank you as always. May God bless you and your family abundantly. This is Michael. Maranatha.